smell so. That was a multi-part question, Dave, and it's long and complicated. Fortunately, we have a copy of it here. Should public employees have the right to form unions of bargain? Yes, of course. Also, I think people in the private sector should. We've lost many, many unions and the rights those people have in private industry over the last few years. And I think that's a critical thing that we also need to talk about and support. I would favor the restoration of collective bargaining rights. How would I accomplish that? Well, there's a big argument going on. Mayor Barrett wants to call a special session. Republicans don't show up. Calvin wants to put in the budget. The budget doesn't pass, and it doesn't have to pass. Then we go on with the current budget for months and months, possibly, if we're in some sort of a stalemate and the Republicans still control the assembly. So I don't think those are the ways to do it. The ways to do it are what I said a little bit ago. Campaigning across the state as governor, and Governor LaFalle will do that. And I think I have the reputation of maturity and common sense that people will listen. And progressive Republicans can be elected, and Democrats, so we do control the assembly, and we have a chance to actually restore it in a legal way. In the meantime, what I would do as governor is sit down and talk to the state employees, many of whom work in my office. You know, we can talk to each other, we can argue about the little details of what people want and what people don't want. We can't give the store away, the budget is not that rich, but we can discuss it. We don't need to drop a bomb on state employees the way Mr. Walker did. And as governor, I would do that until we can restore them in a legal sense, hopefully next year. Should this apply to the broader sector? I mentioned that. You know, private union employees have been having difficult times going back to the air traffic controllers and the union that was broken. And the National Labor Relations Board has been useless in Washington. We need a president, and Mr. Obama, hopefully next year, will be able to stand up and do something about that Labor Relations Board to give workers in the private sector the rights that they also need. How does collective bargaining fit into my campaign? Well, I'll talk about it. But it's not the only issue. It's one of many issues, and I think the Democrat candidate for governor would be well advised not to make it a single issue, because there are a lot of voters. There are a lot of voters out there that may not be totally sympathetic to a one-issue candidate. There's education, there's healthcare, there's women's rights, there's the environment, many issues that I've worked on for years. I'll be honest and say, I think it is a mistake for the unions to have jumped in and made endorsements. I think they should be waiting until the primary is over, because all the Democrats are on their side. We don't need to cause this kind of a friction issue. How would I present the issue to the public? I'd be straightforward and honest about it. I would remind people that when union employees in the private or public sector are doing well and getting benefits and getting health care, non-union workers get those benefits eventually too, because it rubs off on them. And that's been known and documented for years in labor circles. So there's a benefit to everyone to have union employees and also well-paid middle-class citizens who can keep the economy going and provide jobs for all.
Thank you, David. I strongly support public employee rights collectively bargaining. It was something that I made a big step to try and stop and to slow down the process and let people understand what was happening when I and my colleagues went to Illinois. I support Senate Bill 233, which is a bill written by Senator Risser and all of the other Senate Democrats. I'd like to see that bill come forward very early in the next session. It's already been written. It needs to get passed. I wouldn't rule out vetoing the budget, but I think that the strategy is flawed for a number of reasons. First of all, there's broad public support for collective bargaining for public employees. Everywhere I go, even in non-union areas, people believe that workers should have the right to collectively bargain. It's part of democracy, it's part of our American way. In the private sector, it's been part of our history for 100 years. In the public sector, it's been part of our history for 50 years. It's much more likely to pass on its own than any other way. And if you doubt me, recall what happened in 2007 When we put Healthy Wisconsin, Senate Democrats put Healthy Wisconsin into the budget, and the budget didn't pass, and it didn't pass, and it didn't pass until very late that fall. And when I think about how to change things, I think that changing this starts on the very first day of the new governor's, when the new governor is sworn in. Because right now we have many difficult state problems, and we'll be able to touch on a few of them today, but there's a lot more that I can tell you about what's happening in state government that's wrong. And the answers to finding how to resolve those things that are wrong lie within the wisdom of the public employees. The state workers have the wisdom and the knowledge and the expertise, but they have been muzzled by the current administration. They have been told that they cannot speak out. And as executive, we all know, if you own or operate a business or have been a manager, you know, our human resources are our most important resources. And any wise administrator lifts up the voice of those workers and says, you and I are in partnership together, and together we will solve the problems in the state that the state faces. And that needs to happen on day one for the new governor. And by changing the tone and by showing how state workers can help solve these very difficult, complicated problems, I do believe that public support will continue to grow. And we will find, even with a very small Republican leaders, majority in the Assembly, and I don't believe that we should cede the Assembly to the Republicans, but say it does happen. Absolutely, I don't believe we should cede it. I completely agree with what Doug said. But if it happens, remember, I know who those Republican legislators are. I work with them because I live in the swing districts in western Wisconsin, where many of those recently, those rookie Republicans were elected. I know them, I've worked with them.